Okay, so we finished the mountains. We finished the layers in between the mountains and the trees, and we finished the trees in the green field. Now let's work on the chimney and the roof, and maybe some of the section down here. My daughter is to my right, so she may be talking or singing or something, so we'll deal with that when the time comes. But yeah, so basically that's pretty much what's going to happen. Okay, let's draw. So what I would like to do here is give the roof some highlight, kind of shade it so that it looks like it's the light is falling on the roof straight down, is kind of what I'm going for here. So we'll see how it turns out. It shouldn't be too bad. It's grayscale. It's a grayscale area. And I had pretty good faith that this will actually pan out for the best because of it. I'm happy with how the colors are coming together. It's still a little monochromatic, but it's okay. So we put some light there. And these shingles are kind of in a state of disarray. So I'm gonna just, I'm gonna rough in some highlights essentially, and then maybe there's this whole side is like a brighter color because it's like pushed up a bit. But yeah, I'm just gonna go through here and fix the shingle highlights here. I'm not gonna flip into the other color yet. I want to stay with this color. So one of the things for time saving that I learned throughout the years, and it's probably not as applicable now as it was in the old days, was don't change your colors. Like every time you drop a block, don't just change your color palette, your background and foreground colors, just because you're like in a new section or whatever. Just keep kind of, again, scanning through, like kind of like you would with like your mental renderer, your mental ray tracer, whatever you want to call it. Keep scanning through because you can save some time by not changing your colors around and just add where you need to. So you'll see I've left some blanks here, and this might actually stay depending, but like here is an example where I'm going to put an F5 with a, or rather an F6. Sorry, excuse me. Yeah, so that's my advice for people to save some time and frustration. The less you, and actually here I'm going to leave some of the dark. Actually, I'm going to leave a lot of the dark here, so it looks like this is casting a shadow over here this way. Because we don't really have a color darker than this gray color, and we're going to have to stay kind of toony because of all the detail with these shapes, these squares that are kind of thrown in here. We have to make sure that we keep, see here again, this will be where I add that top, those top blocks with a background of light gray and a foreground of dark gray. But anyway, yeah, that saves time. That's my point. That's good. It's fine. Now here, I kind of want to have a little bit. So if I'm casting a shadow this way, the shadow's gonna fall like more, kind of like on this angle here, like from here to here, I'd say. Because if the sun's above us, that means that. And actually, let's take into account this board also and give him some shadow. Because if the sun is above us, then anything that's kind of slightly leaning, if it's at 12 o'clock, I guess, up in the sky, then it will cast a small shadow. It won't be like a long shadow. In this case, if I'd like to put some shadow down here a little bit, but not over here because it's kind of leaning this way, and that won't look right. It will kind of invalidate the shadow we put over here. So let's keep that in mind as we go. So I'm going to put kind of a an intenser shadow, intenser, more intense area over here, and also this is kind of kicked up a bit, so we're not going to fight that too much. We might actually add some on the bottom of this one because the light would be hitting it and then Not so much up here, maybe. Right. Yep. Okay. So let's take a look at this. Looks like there's some wood kind of piercing out of here. I'm going to leave that. I'm going to cast a shadow that's straight down this way. And then I'll also cast a little bit of shadow here. So let's leave some of that unshaded. We might contradict ourselves later. Yeah, I like that so far. Mm-hmm. Oops. That looks good. Yep. Okay. So as we get farther away from the chimney up here, the light will start playing more in this section. Also, I moved the webcam down in the bottom right so we could see the full thing up at the... Presuming it's working, the light is on. I don't know if that's gonna fix it or what, but anyway, it's down in the bottom right now for this stuff. I think it makes more sense. Whoa, sorry for yawning so much. I'm really tired today for some reason. I wasn't up that late. It's up a little while, not super late. Okay, this section, so let's see. This is like a caved in piece. This is gonna be interesting. So over here, it looks like it kind of just was trying to draw a hole maybe, and I didn't get very far in the idea. It definitely was hinting towards a hole. Let's clean that up a little bit as we go, because some of this little detritus or whatever, however you say it, detritus, is gonna be goofy looking maybe. Okay. This would be kind of like that. I'll come back to that one. It's like pushed in more than it is. More than it is pulling out, so I think that's the right light source. The shading, so I should mention this, the shading I learned through regular old art class when we did, what was it called? Still Life, I think it was called. And you basically analyze where the light is coming from, and then you draw the shadows in, you know, because we were working on paper in art class. I don't know why I did that. The place there was light would be no shading, right? So you couldn't like make white really. We didn't, I guess you could if you had pastels or something, but we didn't. We were just drawing with pencils at the time. And anyhow, the exercise was to like, there was like these foam balls and like a cone, and I think there was like a basket of fruit or something. So this right here is a gutter also, and we're gonna touch that up. I'm not gonna mess with it too much right now, but anyway, this right here definitely should be brighter, like because it's sticking out more behind or through here. So let's make that pretty bright. But anyway, you would draw the still life in shade with the pencil. And so I learned all of my kind of shading ideas through that experiment that we had in class. That was a lot of fun. The still life was hard to get right perfectly, but some people were just naturals at it, you know, like I wasn't a natural at it. I was okay. I found that it was hard to make realistic shadows because, like, I didn't know at the time about the umbra and the, what do you call it? The umbra is, like, the darkest part of the shadow, and then there's, like, the, I can't remember what they call it. the Blossom or something. I think I'm making that up. I don't know what it was called. But anyway, yeah. So, and then we did figure drawing a little bit too in that same class, and that was a lot of fun. Okay. Not sure what's going on with this red brick. Maybe it's just hanging out there. I'm not sure. But that already looks pretty decent. Looks like an approximation of some shingled area that's been caved in. Going along this line, there's a shadow coming down through here. So like this whole piece, like that way, right? Because if it's above, then it's gonna come stick out a little bit, that chimney, and it's gonna go fall that way. And then this piece here, I should definitely refine that a little bit more, make it a little bit more obvious. Okay, so now I'm gonna flip around to the other color that I need. So a background of this color and a foreground of that one, so that I can get some more details like this put in. And then I'll go over it again once I have these lines etched in more detail. Yeah. I'll go over it several more times. Mm-hmm. And I always forget pieces that I should have gotten beforehand. Like this right here, I could have done with that other color, but it's okay. It doesn't have to be perfect. Just pretty decent. What else could we add in here that, a roof that's torn up with shingles, just broken and stuff. What else? There would be nails and nail holes like hanging out, probably. So maybe some dot patterns a little bit more. That seems like a no-brainer kind of thing for a situation like we have here. Oops. I'm just gonna stay really solid and I'll go back and smooth some things out as needed. Looks like that's more of a, that's actually, and I'm gonna go through and probably add some anti-aliasing as well. That's another thing we're going to be doing also, is a lot of the checker patterns. Just because a shingle definitely would have something that looked like that in this setup. Looks like I need to fill in some stuff here pretty much. But that's kind of casting a shadow there downward. Let's put that back. Let's actually make it a little bit less even. Something like that. That's better. I'm looking over at the preview window here to check my work so far with the highlights and stuff. That's gonna change, but whatever. Go with it for now. This one down here should probably have more of a pokey out piece. Yeah. And maybe this is brighter also. Kind of that way. Yeah, stop doing Okay. It's looking a little bit better. I'm still not pleased with it totally, but I think this part would probably have some more light. If this is casting a shadow, then the light would be here, right? Like the light source. Picking up the color with Alt U. Yeah. That looks more realistic, I guess you could say. Because the light would be falling down, and if that's lifted up or kicked over a bit. Okay. Shadow more intense. Let's do something like that to kind of keep the eye tricked into believing that that is a shadow indeed. It's looking better. Right, and in the same way that we just did that, let's do a little bit more over here maybe. Right. Here, there would probably be a little bit there. Definitely something like that. Definitely up here. Need some more of these half blocks. What, honey?
I can't do this thing.
What are you trying to do? Let's see.
Find Zoe.
Where is she?
She's hiding.
We'll keep looking. Maybe she's behind the bush?
No.
No? Maybe she's behind the car?
No.
Is she up in the window?
No.
Did you check the mailbox? No. What about behind the tree?
On the tree?
Yeah.
Nope.
No? What about, did you try to open the door?
No.
No. Where is she at? Let's see.
What happened?
Hold on.
This is the better game.
Pause. Shift F9. Okay. So yeah. The shading. Because it's like up on top, it would be brighter, I would imagine. Yeah. Looks more convincing that way. Down here, it's going to be pretty interesting. This would be a little brighter too here, right? And I'll fix that in a minute. This one, there's a I'm not sure what the heck that's supposed to be. A wood board, I'm guessing. That looks better. Looks better. It looks better. Gonna have to use that gray color now. Right. Maybe there. Yeah, some anti-aliasing is going to make this come together really nice once I get to that point. Okay, it's looking a little better. So there's, this part is tricky because of the way that the angle is set up. So, and also with this drop shadow here and here, this looks like butt. We'll fix it. Not sure what's going down there. I'm just gonna. I think that was supposed to be smoke. I'll deal with that later. Give me a half black, you jerk. You jerk. Right. Okay. With that for now. Okay. Let's just work on the roof right now. Let's not worry about the bricks. I want to focus and keep my mind on one topic. Next thing we're doing is anti-aliasing some of these edges. That's definitely going to happen. For sure. This is a painstaking process, but it will pay off, I feel. What's painful about it is just rescanning again, and also the behavior of the background and the foreground color there. Just throws me for a loop. I'm used to doing F6s instead of F5s everywhere. So, apologies for the monotony. This medium is a little bit monotonous sometimes. If you let it be, like, it's fun. Like, I'm having an okay time doing this, but I'm sure watching it probably isn't the best time. I'm sure it's not a lot of fun. Hi, Ella.
That's cool.
Thanks. What does that look like? Look up here. What's that look like?
A mountain.
Yeah. And what's this look like?
Trees.
Yeah. Very good. I'm glad you were able to identify it. That makes me feel good. Because if you know what it is, odds are pretty good other people will too. Right?
And that's a monkey.
It is a monkey. How do you know it's a monkey? What's monkey-ish about it?
Is it a monster?
He looks like a monster?
Yeah.
Does he look like a monster, though?
I think so.
You think so? Okay. We'll go with it.
Well, he's so weird.
He's kind of weird, huh? Your hair got in my face.
Sorry. This. Stop it.
Okay. Stop.
You can't see.
I'm still seeing right now. I see. See, adding that anti-aliasing in just there really refined the way that it looked, softened it up a bit,
yeah.
Which isn't necessarily something that I was going for, but we'll deal with it. Thank you, honey, for the hug.
Where's that dice?
The dice are at work. She's talking about my role-playing dice.
And you bring them back.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Dad.
I'll bring them back. Yep. You're welcome, sweetie.
What are you doing?
I'm drawing. What are you doing?
I want to draw.
You want to draw?
Yeah, I want to draw right there.
Okay, hold on. You can help, okay?
Okay.
Just a minute, though. Let me get this part.
I want pink.
There's no pink. Well,
it's pink over there.
That's kind of pink. That's magenta. It's bright purple, actually.
No, that's pink.
Okay.
I want to do that.
All right, hold on. You can help.
Tickle, tickle, tickle. There's dice on your shirt.
Yeah, there are. What does it say on my shirt?
No, rolling dice.
Rolling dice?
Yeah.
That's one interpretation.
What?
That's one interpretation.
Cool.
Okay. almost done with this pass.
Love you
too.
So, New Year's is not almost here.
New Year's is the next holiday.
Yeah. And what's that for?
What's after New Year's?
Yeah.
Don't step on that cord. Please.
Valentine's.
Let's see. It sounds right. I'll buy that. I'll believe you.
I love you.
I love you too, sweetie. Very much.
Where's your heart?
My heart?
Yeah.
It's right here.
Where's mine?
Same place. Let's see. Over here.
Right here?
Mm-hmm.
Mine's not going fast.
Yours is going fast?
Nope.
It's not?
Nope.
Okay, let's see. Now, let's take the other pass through. What are you doing?
Nothing.
Nothing? Nothing? You're doing nothing?
Yeah.
It looks like you're doing something. What are you doing?
My heart is right here.
Oh, you're trying to get your heart rate up so that you can feel it? No, it's not.
It is.
It's here.
No, it's right here.
Let's see. Let me hear it. Okay, yeah, I hear it.
Do it again.
Okay, wait.
Do it again.
Wait. Are you drawing ANSI?
Yeah, pretend.
For pretend?
Yeah, for like
I can
you.
Teach you how to do it.
I'm gonna do it.
Okay, hold on. Wait a minute. Let Daddy finish doing this anti-aliasing, okay? Then I show you. All right?
Okay.
So do you see when I'm drawing
these yeah.
tiny little dots? Oh, let's stop. You're gonna clip the microphone. Do you see that right here?
Yes.
So you see this little line?
Yeah.
Look at my fingers. When I go like this, what does the line do?
Colors.
It moves to the left and right. So if you go this way, the line goes that way. If you go this way, the line goes that way. Right? Uh-huh. I'll show you more about it later.
Okay.
You tired?
That's a little. I don't want to take a nap.
You don't want to take a nap?
Nope.
Okay.
I love you.
I love you too, sweetie. Very, 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 very much.
I hear my heart up and they give me down, okay?
Hold on. Okay, let's pause. Okay, file, save as. Yes. Okay. So. This is what you do. These are arrow keys, okay? And you go down. You see the little dot moving up and down?
Yeah.
Don't look here, look up here. See? It's moving?
Yeah.
Move down. You see? And then move right. You see it's moving to the right? And then move left. Make a finger, okay? There you go. Now if you go all the way down, it starts to scroll the screen, kind of like the iPad.
No.
There's the monkey face, right? So, you want to draw a booger in his nose?
Yeah.
All right, that's gross. Let's do that. So let's put it over here. Okay.
Yeah.
What color should the booger be?
I don't know.
What color are boogers? Green?
Oh, green, yeah.
Green, okay. So now this, you know how to use the mouse, right?
Yeah.
So use the mouse. Up, stop, go over here and pick green. Good job. And put the cursor back here. Let go. Okay. Now what you do is down here, there's a bunch of different blocks. You see on the bottom?
Mm-hmm.
And then this, so this one goes with that one. This one goes with that one and so on. So to draw a green booger, you would do, make a pointer, do F3.
Yeah.
Ew, yucky.
Yeah.
And how about, wait, let's do an F1. Oh, yeah. Oh, that's a gross booger.
Gross.
Let's undo that a little bit, okay?
Gross.
And then let's, maybe it's red and green, because it's a bloody booger. Ugh.
Yeah.
That's disgusting. F5. See how it says F? F, F, F. These are function keys. So F5, F6, F7, F8. So F5. Oh, jeez. Yucky.
Gross.
Ew.
Gross.
That's disgusting.
It's
gross. We need to put some brown on there, too.
We need to have a bloody.
There. Ew, he's got bugs. Do you want to draw something else? Let's draw down here.
Yeah.
Let's draw a flower? Or what? You want to draw a flower? Or what? What do you want to draw?
I
want to
draw a flower.
Okay. What color should the flower petals be?
Yellow.
Yellow?
Yeah.
Okay, pick yellow.
Okay.
Move this over there and pick yellow.
Right here?
Yeah, okay. Good job. Now okay, let go. Let me show you. Click off. Okay. Now we're going to use the pen tool, or the paintbrush, and now you can draw. Making a flower shape. You see?
Yeah.
Pretty cool, huh?
Yeah.
That's a pretty flower.
Yeah. What? Now let's use blue.
Okay. Go ahead, pick blue.
Right here?
Sure. Now go ahead and draw. Good job.
Now green.
Okay.
Green is right here.
Uh-huh. For a stem? Wow, that's very good. You're very good at this. You're a great ANSI artist. That's very good, La. High five. Okay, so what else should we draw?
I don't know.
Let's shade the flower a little bit.
Okay.
Give some more detail. That's interesting. It doesn't do well on the, I guess it wouldn't unless it was the background color. Let me fix that. So we'd have to enable ice color or this maybe. Nope. Mm-hmm.
What are you doing?
Just adding some shading.
Why?
And actually let's make the brush smaller. Then you can draw like that. Along the edge. I like your flower better than my flower.
Yeah.
You did a better job. And pink?
Pink, my favorite.
That's your favorite?
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
What are you doing to gray?
I don't know. Just playing.
I want to play.
Go ahead, play. Good job.
Okay, now at the cons. Oh, this one. Pink.
Okay.
Spots.
Spots on the flower? Yeah, that's good. Because flowers do have spots on them, don't they?
Yeah.
That's a good job.
Okay. Uh-huh.
Very good.
Oops.
That's okay. If you make a mistake, you can hold down Control Z and it will undo. Is that good?
Yeah. Right. Now it comes. What color?
Maybe purple?
Purple? This is purple?
No, you don't see the purple? Right here.
I can't.
See where brown is?
Yeah.
Up above brown is purple. Yeah. There you go, it's good. Draw. Wow. That's pretty cool, La. Are you making stripes?
Yep, for my flower.
That's cool.
Flowers do have stripes.
They do have stripes. It looks like someone spilled paint on the flower, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Now you can pick, if you want to draw lines, you can pick that one. Or if you want to draw squares, you pick that one, or circles, that one. There you go. You got it.
There.
Good job.
Oh, well, how do I get out the circles?
Oh, go back to the brush. Yep. And if you want a bigger brush, you can click on the up arrow or the down arrow. Up arrow makes it bigger.
I want a bigger one.
A bigger one? Okay. Then make it. Gotta go over here. It's kind of fiddly. There you go. Try that.
Cool. Ah, that's so awesome. Do you like my flower?
I do. It's very abstract.
It's your turn.
Okay. What should we draw together?
I don't.
How about a snowman?
Oh, snowman for winter.
You like snowmans, right?
Yep.
Okay. There's his head.
Yep.
And then underneath is his body.
Yeah.
It's his big body, right?
Yeah.
And that's actually too big. A snowman has three pieces typically, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Let's do one more on the bottom. Like Frosty, right?
Frosty, the snowman.
Or even like, Olaf from Tangled.
How about Frosty?
Okay, Frosty the Snowman. Okay, corn cob pipe and a button nose. Let's see, orange would be, I guess, this color? Sure. What color should his hat be?
I don't know.
How about blue?
Okay.
Like that?
Mm. Yeah, in the stripe.
In a stripe? Okay, we'll put a stripe on in a sec.
Yeah.
Right. Actually, that looks like a pimp hat.
Yeah.
It's not a very good snowman hat.
No.
We'll fix it. Hold on. There, that's a little better. In a stripe? What color should the stripe be?
I don't know.
How about this color? Yeah? Do you like that?
Yes.
Okay, now let's draw the buttons.
Button and the button nose, a broomstick on his hand.
That's right. Oh, we gotta draw the broomstick on his hand. I'm in the line tool. Oops.
That's okay.
Hold on, let's fix that. Let's take it to here. That's probably better. Nope.
He's doing one.
There we go. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. How's that?
Yeah.
And a broomstick in his hand?
Yes.
Okay. Let's see. Which hand? This one?
Yeah.
And a broomstick in his hand. Wait a minute. Whoops.
Oops.
Now we need, what color should the broom be? Yellow, I guess. Because the broom was made out of straw and stuff. There's a crappy broomstick. Not very good. It's okay.
Yeah. What else?
I don't know. What do you think?
About a castle.
A castle?
Yeah.
Okay. What color should the castle be? Gray? Like gray, like bricks?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's not sticky or yucky, right?
Right. Okay, so it's like this.
That's the door.
This is the door?
No, that's the castle, the block.
This is the block, right?
Yeah.
And then we'll draw this thing. Right, like that? And then And this is the other tower in the castle?
Yeah.
Okay.
Make a big one.
Okay, wait. And then let's use brown?
Yeah, brown.
For the drawbridge?
Yeah, the drawbridge.
Like that?
Yeah.
That looks pretty cool.
Yeah.
And then maybe the castle has holes in for windows here?
Yeah.
Like that?
Yeah.
It's kind of fun. And then maybe there's some chains connecting the drawbridge up to the castle?
Yeah.
Like that?
Yeah.
Okay. And maybe there's holes around it. Like that. Right?
That's pretty cool.
That's not too bad. Whoops.
Edit,
undo. Edit, undo. Okay.
Sorry.
Mm-hmm. It's okay. We're making the little lines at the top of the castle, the ballistas or whatever they're called.
I know.
See, look. Like that. Yeah. Something like that?
Yeah.
Oops. We screwed up. There we go. Like that. And then around the edge of the door, maybe, like this. How's that look? That's a cool looking castle, La. You did a good job. Okay, now these probably have some highlights up here, huh?
Oh, need some blue. Hey, wait a second.
Okay,
it's
okay.
My turn.
Your turn.
Need a windows like this.
Oh, yeah, good point. We need windows in our castle. Very good.
Not great. That's only blue.
That's pretty good. Oh, I see, because it's got glass. The windows are made out of glass. That makes sense, you know? That's smart. You're a smart lady.
There.
Good job.
That's fine.
Okay.
There.
All right. Then what should we have? Maybe there's maybe the door has some lines in it?
No, yeah.
Because it's wood planks, right?
Yeah.
Like this? Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. And then,
That's my castle party.
That's your castle party?
That's my party.
Okay.
Looking for.
You're gonna have a party in the castle?
Yeah.
Like Frozen did?
Yes.
Okay.
It's not Frozen.
I know it's not Frozen, but it's like Frozen, right?
Yeah, it's only a movie.
Right.
That's my castle party.
Uh-huh. Good.
I've been there so long all day.
You've been there so long all day?
Yeah. Because there's music and windows and doormobs.
Doormobs?
Yeah.
What's a doormob?
You knock on the door.
Oh, gotcha. A doorknob.
Yeah.
Gotcha. Because you said doormob. But that's okay, right?
Yeah.
People talk different.
It's my turn now.
Okay, go ahead. What else are we going to draw on there? Are we done with the castle yet, or are we going to draw something else? Whoa, what's that?
It's a roof.
That's a sweet roof. That is awesome. Can I show you something?
Oops.
Wait, let me show you. Hold on. Let's see. Wait, don't press anything. Let's see how far the undo goes back. Just a minute. I want to make the brush bigger for you, okay?
Okay.
So you don't have to draw as goofy. Okay. See, right here, we're going to make the brush bigger. Okay, now you draw your roof.
Okay.
Better? Is that better?
Yeah.
Okay. Are you going to fill it in?
Oops.
You're doing a good job. You're doing a great job, La.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
This is the castle roof.
That's a very good roof. Now, it looks very yellow.
Yeah, now candles on the castle.
Candles on the castle, okay.
There.
That's very good. Should we put some fire on the candles?
Sure.
Like red fire?
Yeah, it's hot.
It is hot. Careful.
You get boo-boo.
You get a boo-boo from it. Okay, what else should we draw on the castle?
My turn.
Okay.
How about sun?
Okay. Wait, go ahead. You could just draw it like that, yeah, that's good. That's a great sun. Are those the sunbeams?
Yeah.
That's great, high five on that. Okay. What else? What's this? What's that?
It's our, it's the castle, it, that's the princess's garden.
That's the princess's garden?
Yeah.
Okay. I see, so this is a top-down view of the castle then?
Yeah.
Gotcha. That's pretty cool, Lau. You did a good job. What else?
And there's red on it.
On the sun?
Yeah.
Okay.
Because it's hot, because you touch it, you get burned.
You touch it, you get burned. You get a boo-boo.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You go to the doctors.
You gotta go to the doctor.
Oops.
That's okay. If you don't want that, Daddy got rid of it. What's that, flower in the garden?
It's a it's a dog. It's a dog house.
A dog house? Oh, okay. There's two dogs?
No, I don't have. There's dogs sleeping in there.
Oh, the dogs are sleeping in there?
Yeah.
Gotcha. That makes sense.
Brown floor, right here.
Was that the dirt road?
No, it's the stairs.
The stairs. Oh, I see. Very good.
There.
Oh, good. So the dogs can get out of their house?
Yep.
I see.
Okay. Maybe I need some white.
That's yellow.
Oh, yeah.
Down one more is white. There you go. Is this clouds? Smoke? Yeah. What is it?
No, it's clouds.
Clouds, okay.
By the sun.
By the sun, that's right. Up in the sky, huh?
There.
Good job. That's very good.
What else on the castle?
Maybe some blue for the sky, that color. Maybe some blue sky.
Oops, that's gray.
Sure.
Okay.
Just kind of, yeah. That's good. You did a great job. Pretty good, La. I'm interested to see where you're taking this next. So what is that?
It's water for the... That's a bubble bath for the dogs.
Okay.
It's a tub.
It's a tub? Okay.
Yeah.
Sorry. You're funny. You cracked me up. Okay, go ahead.
Okay, now water. Okay. Water for here. And water for...
Oh, in the tub.
Yeah, it's the tub.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
It's looking really good, La.
No, you didn't. You
okay,
didn't.
Let's draw grass around the castle then.
Yeah.
Okay. I've been holding this in my mind the whole time you were drawing.
And bushes, too.
And bushes?
Yeah.
Okay.
Be careful of the dog bath.
I'm not going to touch the dog's bath, okay? There you go. Oops.
What happened?
I went over the brown on accident. I got it.
You got that too.
No, that was like that. It's fine. Right?
Bushes too.
Okay, we'll draw bushes. That's a pretty cool castle. This will be the bushes. You like that? How about a tree?
Oh, yeah!
Let's draw a tree over here. And then with leaves on it. That's good. And another tree with leaves. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Hey, it looks like a heart, kind of.
Yeah.
That's very good. Let's see. Let's fill in the sky a little bit more. Right?
By the clouds.
Yep.
Oops.
It's okay. It's not an exact science, right?
Yeah, it's a little hard.
Kind of, but you're doing a good job.
Yeah.
That's the main thing. If you're having fun, that's the main thing, right?
No!
What?
Look.
Oh, that's the microphone.
Why? What?
So they can hear us, because we're recording this right now.
That's so funny!
Uh-huh. Okay, here, wait. Where are you going?
Come what?
Here. Drop here and here. There. Oh. Beautiful.
Sorry.
It's okay. Okay, that's a great castle picture.
Let's make something else.
What do you want to make?
Down.
Okay, now I want to show you how to go down. Make a pointer and put your finger up. Do you see this says page? Page. P-A-G-E. That spells page. 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 Okay. page down. So press that. There you go.
Yeah.
Brand new page. Now what do you want to draw?
I want to make a mama snowman.
A mama snowman? Okay.
That is his head.
Her head?
Yeah, her head.
Okay.
Okay, now her body's like this, right?
Sure. Why not?
Because.
Okay.
Oh, this is a kid.
It's a kid one?
Yeah.
Okay. It's fine. Let's change it up.
That's mine.
That's a good job.
That's
you. Snow. Oops.
Oops.
Oops. Do you want to undo that?
No.
You want to leave it?
Yeah, I just have feet. Right?
Mm-hmm. It's pretty cool how it's making shapes for you like that, huh?
This is the pink eyes.
Wow, that's pretty sweet. Nice job. Looks kind of like E.T. so far. What's that?
The buttons.
Oh, okay. What's this, the nose or the hat?
It's a hat.
Great. Is that the carrot nose or the mouth?
The mouth.
Okay, that's great.
This is orange. Oops. This is okay.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yeah, looks good.
Ta-da!
It's a good job.
I did it.
You did it. And you remember cage down. Very good. What should we draw? Let go. What should we draw now?
I don't know.
How about...
We draw.
We got a book. How about a Christmas tree?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. So a Christmas tree starts with a trunk, right? Like this. Okay. And then on top of that, there's branches, right? You tired?
No, I don't want to take a nap.
I know. It's fine, you don't have to.
Oopsie.
There's a Christmas tree. What do you think of that? And then let's put a star on? Ella?
Yeah.
Okay. Stop shouting in my ear. Okay?
I'm just laughing.
I know, but it hurts my ear. And then let's put on ornaments. Right?
Yeah, ornaments.
Ornament.
It's only pink.
And some of that. And maybe that.
Your voice is very quiet.
Right?
Right.
Oh, Christmas tree, oh, Christmas tree. How lovely are your branches. Right?
Right.
Yeah. Or what was it that you were saying? Are you a Christmas tree? A Christmas tree. That's the one you learned in school?
No, you're the perfect tree, the perfect tree, the perfect tree. Oh, you're the perfect tree, and I'd sparkle on Christmas Day.
Okay. That's a good song. Let's make the star more star-like. Okay.
Okay.
That's like more like a... It's not really a star, but that's okay. That's not bad. Now let's draw some presents. Right?
Yeah.
Ella, don't touch my glasses. Thank you.
They're tickling me.
Sorry. There's one. Who's this one to?
Me.
To you?
Yeah.
That's selfish. Okay.
And yours.
Let's draw a bow on it. Okay.
Your mom's are green and yours are black.
Mine are black. Black presents on Christmas.
No, it's pink. No, yours are blue.
Okay. Yeah, because black isn't a very good Christmas color.
No.
Let's do green with yellow. Right?
All right. You,
this is a bow up here.
You, that's the perfect.
That's very good. It looks good, doesn't it?
Yeah.
You want to do any?
No.
Are you all done drawing?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, Daddy's not done though, so you gotta leave me alone for a little while yet, okay? And then we'll go and play. Okay?
Okay.
All right.
Let's go play.
Okay, so taking another shot at this. It was interrupted last time. Hopefully that won't happen again. Or if it does, it won't be as interrupty. So let's just keep going through here, make sure we've got all of our work done that needs to be done for this pass. Thinking right there. Let's leave it like that. For now, we'll fix it. This is weird. I don't know what I was thinking there either. Okay, let's start adding some shades now from this brighter area. Actually, let's add some intense highlights real quick before we go too much farther down this path. So we're going to use bright white on this light gray where it's appropriate. And where that is appropriate depends on what needs to be achieved, I guess, for the light source. So here, I'm not going to use any, because, and actually, maybe that should be dropping a shadow. I don't want to add a ton of it, but enough to kind of sprinkle it in here and there. Just because it's going to add a little bit more of, I guess, realism when there's gradations of the actual highlight. Right, should be intense here. There's probably some there. Thinking about this would probably be like that. So just adding some highlights through the roof area so that we get even more of an intense shadow play, I guess, too. That's also a side effect of doing this. Even though I've only added a few blocks of bright white, it's still pretty different than what it was before. It's not a very scientific thing to say, but it's true, so whatever. I'm not a scientist, man. Alright, right, so there's shadow here. Maybe there's something going down there. And maybe one there. So one thing that I can't do is use white as a background color, because that would be an ice color.
Excuse me.
So as a result of not being able to do that, I kind of have to stick with some more intense spots of shading, as you'll see, because I'm just not able to because of the ice color requirement. I could use this light gray on white in order to achieve something like that, but I don't want to undo the work I did with the anti-aliased edges. Okay, it's looking a little better. I still feel like there's issues over here, but in here, like the top looks okay. This is pretty rough down here. Let's add a little bit more, I guess, consistent shading maybe. It just looks a little wonky, you know? Maybe it's because it's too piecemeal over here with this hole, which is also a possibility, but it could also be that, you know, you can do a better job at making it look a little bit more conformant to the rest of the shingles. Especially through there. And the light sources are all over the place here, so this is really tricky to shade anyway on top of it. So, yeah. It's a little bit better. So I'm using this preview to like check my work basically. So, and now that I've done that, I can add a little bit more bright white as well. I'm also starting to think that maybe I can do some straight up to the edge shading with the highlights. It sounds like my daughter's coming in. I'm trying to. That's fine. We'll let her. I don't want to discourage her from any creative pursuit, you know? She's welcome. It's looking like a dark textured roof, I guess. Those look more like shingles than they did before. Now I need to blend quite a lot of it, because otherwise if I don't, the harsh contrast between these two pieces, like for instance, these two pieces here, this white, gray, and dark gray, it's going to look too harsh. So let me illustrate down here on where I've done it with the metal. So. Here is an example of an anti-aliased edge, and then here's an example of some bright shading that is smoothed out a little bit, so it gives it more of the appearance of metal. But here's an example where it's almost like burned in, right? And it's got high contrast because it's metal, right? So I'm kind of going for something more like this, and I might actually use a similar approach and just fuzz things around a bit and lose some of the detail on the edges. I might have to as a necessity. Let's see what we can get away with first. I'm really tired. So I had a interesting night last night. My relatives came over and we hosted another party. That was kind of fun. Hadn't seen my sister in forever. So Christmas is still kind of like winding down for me, I guess you could say. Not as much, but still a little bit. Okay, so let me do some texture shading around some of this part and let's see what we can get away with here. That looks pretty good. This was also a brighter way to texture in this case because it's using this white color, right? So something like that is looking pretty decent. But yeah, it's fun seeing the relatives again and hanging out. Ella really enjoys her family. She's a good kid. She has a lot of fun on Christmas time too, which is neat. Because that's what it's all about. That's what it's all about. I'm gonna fill in some of this black too, I think, with some darker gray, which is gonna be tricky to do. And there might be a better way to do this, but I'm not aware of what it is. Just to connect a little bit of this stuff together, give it a little bit more of a, less of a kind of outline, I guess you could say, because it looks a little goofy with that stark, that contrast. All this black going on in this blocky formation. It's difficult to achieve what I'm going for without adding to the toony nature of it. So we're gonna simplify as much as we can as a result. Some of those black lines, and that might mean that we lose a few of them. What am I doing there? I don't want that there. Right. Yep. Mm-hmm. So hopefully, we can achieve that. It's going to be difficult. Oops, that's the wrong way. Actually, what is it? Edit. Control Shift X. Did that? It looks like it. It's black. It doesn't work. I mean, it works on the side and it doesn't look like it's updating properly on the background, or it's because my vice color is disabled. That's what it is. Yeah. Cool. Well, that's kind of nice, actually. He's like, dude, you don't have vice color, so I'm going to do the best I can. Nice. That's pretty cool. Pretty cool indeed. All right. Mm-hmm. Okay, so it's like coming down there. Oops, I feel like I've spent a lot of time drawing lately, which actually feels pretty good. There's something medicinal about this medium. I don't know what it is. I'm not going to try and understand it, but it's definitely, it's like therapeutic for me. And I don't quite understand why. It's a similar feeling of, wait, why? Oh, I guess that's right. It's a similar feeling to when I'm in the zone with music. too. I've noticed there's something that's, some interesting things are happening in my mind. Like, I have the kind of mind that wants to be constantly, like, thinking about things, and that sounds silly, but it's true. Like, it never shuts up, ever. And it's pretty annoying sometimes. Often it will keep me up at night and, like, be quiet, brain. I'm trying to sleep, but it doesn't listen. I guess to think of your own mind as a different piece of yourself is a little bit silly, but whatever. Don't take any of what I say seriously, I guess. It's looking a little better. It's looking like a caved in shingle-ish roof here. We're losing a little bit of the, it almost looks like it's melted too. Like the flatness of the shingles has definitely been affected by the damage, which is kind of neat. I don't know if I was necessarily going for that. Over here on this edge, I definitely want to keep the shingles a little bit straighter. Maybe to emphasize that, look, these two things are different, so this is more damaged. And since this hole is here, that kind of makes sense. Do you know what I'm saying, Mang? All right, let's keep that. Let's keep that kind of idea alive. Keep it alive. But yeah, the brain sometimes doesn't shut up, except for when I'm doing stuff like this. It's like able to, it's able to like chew on it or like digest something, or I don't know, it's happiest when it's doing this kind of thing. And my brain is kind of like a creature, to be honest with you. It's silly to say it, but it is. I have to like pacify it and give it things to do, or it will start bitching at me about other stupid things that I don't care about as much. For instance, you know, resentment, fear, negative emotion of, you know, whatever kind. It definitely does happen. Not often, but enough to bother me. And I have the kind of personality where I don't like to even think stupid negative thoughts, you know? I don't think they're very productive at all. And so when I do have those thoughts, I try and push them away. And that sometimes makes them come back even more. Which is pretty goofy. Pretty silly. It's like it's stuck in a loop. And, you know, it can get so intense sometimes that, I don't know if I want that to be bright. I want some light here. I'll get migraines sometimes if I fight it too much. And those suck. I freaking hate migraines. Of course, who likes them? Maybe a person who's sick in their mind, but, or has like some other kind of neurosis, but I'm pretty healthy mentally, I guess, aside from being crazy and stuff about what I just said. You know, that's kind of crazy. I don't know if that's normal. I think most people have I think most people do have thoughts that just, you know, thoughts like me. I mean, I'm not that unique. They just don't talk about it on YouTube necessarily, which is cool, you know? Everybody's different. Okay. but things just feel different when I'm drawing or writing music or like pursuing some outcome, you know, with my brain when I'm thinking a lot. It just feels better. It feels nice. Like I don't have to fight the tension, you know, like that internal critic and it's constantly like passing judgment on my own thoughts and stuff, which is pretty fucked up when you think about it, but it's how I am. So I can't necessarily fight it. When I try, it doesn't work. So surrender is the strategy. But when I'm doing stuff like this, it's not a problem. I'm definitely able to shut that thing the hell up. That mind. I wonder if the same thing is true for other occupations, like art, programming, those, you know, and like music, any creative outlet that requires, what is it? I guess left brain is, it's like a combination of left brain, right brain. So if you buy into the whole idea that what is it? The left brain is the creative side, the creative hemisphere. Not sure if I buy into that whole concept, but whatever. I think they've proven it with science. But if you believe in that stuff, I guess it would be activities for me that stimulate me most, or they have equal distribution of those two hemispheres of the brain. Because there's an organizational perspective aspect. I'm gonna have to pause for a minute. I'm not, but I might have to. There's an organizational like logic analysis that's occurring here. Like based on my experience of shingles, I know that they're square patterns and whatever, and they can be different colors, of course, but the ones around me that I grew up with are like the square, you know, rectangles. So that's kind of what happened here with this roof, right? So I'm thinking as I'm drawing this stuff and shading it, well, how does this actually look like a shingle? It's damaged, right? So like, anyway, the point I'm making is like all of this analysis is happening at the same time that I'm being creative. So that's pretty cool. And I think that's what really makes my brain happiest. It's when it's having to use its all of its capacity. Both of its hemispheres, maybe not all of it, but you know, both hemispheres at the same time. I'm pleased with how that's turning out. So down here where there's less highlight, I'm gonna get a little bit more blendy. With some of these blocks. One thing that's cool about Pablo that used to happen in other editors that I do have to mention, the cursor never disappears really. Like I can't remember which editor it was. Maybe it was just ITP Draw, I don't remember. But as I would draw, the cursor would literally just disappear and I'd just have to draw a block in order to figure out where I was. It was quirky, but you know, I just suffered with it, you know, because I just preferred that editor. I don't know why it would do it either. Like there was no explanation. Okay, I'm gonna do that. actually. Little of that. Maybe like that. Looks a little better. It's definitely that. Some of that. Maybe some bright white for the edge here. Pieces that kicked up. So yeah, that's my brain works when I'm drawn like this. It's not a constant thing. Like, I don't want you to think that it's always like that, but it definitely favors that kind of mentality. Like, this is... Hey, Ella.